I make vintage kimono jewelry. It's the forgotten kimonos that I find at antique markets and vintage shops. And sometimes people even gift them to me from their own collections. And they're usually forgotten in drawers, these special tansu, they're called, big drawers. And the kimono takes a lot of time to care for it and keep it clean and keep it safe from moths and from mold. And people find it kind of difficult to look after, so they don't want them anymore. The tansu itself takes up a lot of space, so they don't want to have the kimono. They don't even wear the kimono anymore. So they're quite happy to gift it to you. And then I break up the kimono and then I make jewelry from the kimono. I make rings and necklaces and neck pieces, which are quite long and statement, quite bold pieces of jewelry, very colorful. Kimonos are very colorful. I also make rings and earrings, and I make them in my studio, which is pretty small, but it's packed to the top with different kimono fabrics and with many colors and designs. I use a sewing machine mainly to make my jewelry pieces. So I sew the fabric into long tubes and then I create them on the tailor's dummy and make them into different shapes and forms. And then I use pins and I sew them together. I also use resin. So I put kimono into a ring and I put a resin on top, which is a kind of plastic. And then it makes it sort of shiny.